I should, man. Point, point, babe. Do what I could, man. Point, point, babe. Do what I should, man. Point, point, babe. Do what I could, man. Point, 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 babe. Do what I should, man. Point, babe.
I am still waiting for a radio station to reach out and let us do a morning show.
I just feel like I tripped in the club doors and hit my head on the DJ booth because I've been transported. Yeah, where are we right now? We're not where we are, but we are jamming somewhere.
We are on TikTok.
Oh, yep. Okay.
This song can live rent free.
Got it. Whatever she said, folks.
And as far as I know, the words that I can understand and make out, I don't think there's any cuss words.
Oh,
so
oh,
that's there's good. That.
Yeah.
Welcome to another episode of Coaching, Caffeine, and Comedy. I'm your host, Hayley Kobza.
And I'm Lena. So when you say that and you say no cuss words and TikTok, I just watched this little reel of this guy who's a junior high teacher and he makes up slang. And then he goes around and tells the kid that all the other schools, these are the hot words, but they're just totally made up.
And then they start using them probably.
Yes. That's a good idea. I could do that. My job allows me to, well, I don't, I guess, go all over to every other school, but just, we could start making up words.
Yeah. I don't, I mean, but I've met the kids at your school and I don't know if they'd listen to you.
That's 100% true. They would not.
Just, and speaking of your school, I did meet the math teacher that everyone thinks is so cool.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. He was,
Where was this random act of?
It, seventh graders was at
the college.
They were at the college. And so. It was the boys. I saw them and I said, who's this man? They're like, the math teacher. I said, oh, hey, buddy.
Mr. Weezer.
Yeah. So
this is when I was talked about.
Yeah.
But behind
talked
my back.
About you. Yeah. No.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Because I wasn't there. So that means it wasn't.
No, I was like, what do you guys think of Lena? And
yeah. One girl says, she can be a bit much.
Yeah. Yeah. It's sweet of her.
Thanks, Jackson.
And then you just had those really cool hot pants on. So I.
True story.
Completely understood.
Yeah.
So today is May 28th, 2024. It's a Tuesday.
It is.
And it is National Hamburger Day.
Great time. Summertime barbecue.
Yes, let's do everybody it, needs to go to, let's see if you'd get a hamburger where I would. Think my, look at me.
Oh.
You would go to?
You're going to say Max, but I would say Copper Mill or The Loop.
Oh, okay.
I mean, the Max, okay.
You did. You read my soul there.
I know I
nice.
Did.
Yeah.
I mean, come on, Max. That's like a melt in your mouth.
Yeah.
Kind of burger.
Delicious.
If you're going to need a meal for 7 days, something hearty, you're going to The Loop or the Copper Mill.
I don't think I've ever had a hamburger from The Loop. I should test it out.
The Western.
Well, it's Tuesday now, so you should go get me a hamburger.
I can do that.
Thanks.
It's amazing. Well, I don't know if they have gluten-free buns.
They do have gluten-free buns at The Loop.
Okay.
And it's also National Brisket Day. So
they have a brisket burger.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. It's amazing.
Oh, yep. Sorry, I'm getting adjusted here. Did you tighten this bad boy up?
Yeah, no, of course. I don't want you to be concerned about my setup abilities of the equipment. I feel like that's weird.
Okay, so a few things, because I have so much to talk about. First off, let's talk about Women's Golf League.
I feel like the word golf is interesting, but yeah, let's talk about that. Okay. Folks, we are doing it. We are in a golf league.
We are doing hard things.
It's terrifying, and I almost threw up. I almost threw up in the parking lot multiple times.
That's what Evie said. What in the world? You have no idea, though. If you were there that first day, you would have felt what I felt. The anxiety.
Yeah.
I literally, the people that I knew, I was in line next to Kara Marvin, and I just attached myself to her because I was so nervous, and I knew her, so I just, like, clung.
Uh-huh.
Like a small infant that didn't want to go to school that day.
Yes.
So I just followed Kara around.
I saw the pictures of you having your arms wrapped around her leg.
Pretty much.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah. And then some mean woman behind me was telling me all the things I was doing wrong and my outfit wasn't right. And
was that just the voice in your head or was it actually a human being?
No, that was an actual human being. That's when I was texting you and saying, SOS, Lena, no tights. I got to wear a collared shirt. My bag is too old.
They were just harassing you.
Yeah, they were. And then I thought she was serious until after, and she says, you know, I was just beeping with you.
Uh-huh.
I said, that wasn't nice.
No, when you're nervous, it's not good.
Yeah, it was one of those.
I prayed for rain all day long.
Mm-hmm.
I even did a rain dance in my yard. I drove slow.
Trying to be late.
Yes, and my stomach hurt pretty much all day long. So now when I know what kids feel like in junior high for that first track meet.
I still need to make a clip of your first night out at golf. I'll put that on TikTok later this week.
You just do that. I'm very comfortable with my level of play.
Evie told me that your golf clubs were literally brand new, that you were taking the plastic off of them.
I went to hit the first ball and I saw this weird reflection and I was like, wait, Jake told me these were new and I thought it was like a dent or something because I was like, what is wrong with my club?
You still had plastic.
And they are 3 years old. So if that
3 years brand new old, right? I don't know how that works, but I'm with you.
Oh, you don't. Okay. I'm going to give a shout out to Kayla McDonald.
Okay.
And
don't know who she is.
Sweet.
Okay.
And her partner that she was with. Who was she? Her name's going to come to me too. And they're like, you could golf with us. Because I was so nervous and we were by ourselves. So we weren't with another group. And she's like, Ashley Vance. That's the other person she was with.
Okay.
And I was glad that we were by ourselves. I was so, but they were so nice. They're like, it's okay. It'll be fun. But that's how people should make you feel.
Exactly.
Like it was really kind. Yep. I mean, there was lots of people there that were super kind, but it was just like,
then there were some others though that,
well, maybe to you, but I didn't get that. No one made fun of me.
Also weren't in the room when all of them had to meet and have a meeting.
True. And I didn't have anyone in our group. Golfing.
That was
just me and Evie.
And then by the time I got up to where we got water beverages and stuff, they were out of everything. Oh. And it was, everyone was waiting for me. And I was just trying to make a choice of a drink that I've never had before. That was rough.
Yeah. That's embarrassing. Yeah.
But our first time that I was there, we've never golfed together yet. Everyone needs to know that.
Yeah.
I was with Emily Young and Amber Purdy.
Uh-huh.
Sweet people.
Oh,
they were very nice. They were very nice.
That matters, people. It
does.
It really
does. Be kind.
Especially when someone's doing something new. And you know what I realize as a junior high coach, I forget that a lot of the times these girls are coming into a sport, basketball, volleyball, they're coming in at sixth grade. They have never played before.
Good comparison.
Honestly,
for
my golf game, let me tell you. There are sixth graders
that first night, Evie goes to hit the first ball and she's like, wait, I just want everybody to know this is my first time ever playing golf. Mm. And then the competitive side of me got a little angry, but I was like, okay, Evie, you can do it. And she did fine.
So maybe it's good you and I aren't going to be together for a while. I told myself I was going to have a goal of getting out in the yard and hitting. So folks, you have to understand, Cobes and I are on a team, but we have not yet been together at the course at the same time. So she has subbed, Evie has subbed for me with Cobza, and then Evie subbed for Cobza with me.
Yeah. And then
I don't know how many balls you and Evie lost.
Zero.
That's not possible.
Yeah. Yes. I didn't lose it because I know where it is. And that's when I got the poison ivy.
Oh, for gosh sakes. I think she told me about that. She's like, you got to ask Cobza about poison ivy.
Yeah.
And are you as delicate as Jake if it blows in the wind?
I kind of panicked and I was itching and then I was in the golf cart and I said, Evie, has anybody ever died from poison ivy? And
I could use a poison ivy leaf as a loofah. Is that what they call this? A loofah sponge thing?
And I would like to hope you don't put a loofah. I'm just trying to think what you're cleaning with your loofah.
It wouldn't react. Jake and you, obviously, it blows in the breeze and you guys are down and out. Blistered, near death, dying.
Yeah.
No, it doesn't faze me.
Thinking about it, it actually makes me kind of itchy.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. Well, okay.
So we only lost one ball, but I know where it is.
Mm-hmm.
So it's in Rattlesnake Alley or something.
By a poison ivy plant.
Yes.
Evie and I lost 8.
Wow. You know what? Shout out to Tim Zinder, who...
Is he donating? Is he sponsoring us?
Oh, he donated. What's 18 times 3?
4 to 54.
Okay. He donated us 54 balls.
Well, now we're down to 46.
Well, no, I still have all the 54 balls because I didn't give you all the new ones yet.
That's probably a good idea.
Yeah. You took all my pretty lime green ones and lost them.
I did. Okay. Here's the thing. I thought lime green would be easy.
Yeah.
Jake has said I've always been really bad about following the ball when it goes. You know, he's like, you got to track your ball.
Yeah.
I was too distracted giggling or walking or talking that I'd never tracked one of Evie's and I don't think she did mine. So they were gonzo.
I can't wait to golf with you.
Yeah.
I saw a TikTok the other day.
Uh-huh.
We're going to do this. Evie actually sent it to me so I could definitely see her doing this if she subs. You know, like the big marshmallows for s'mores?
Yeah.
People throwing those out on the golf course.
We would never wink do that.
Never.
No.
Mm-mm.
Great idea.
Because people think they're balls.
Yes.
But they're marshmallows.
And then the warmer they get, what a nightmare.
Yeah, and then think of all the raccoons.
Yes. I want Nothnagel to find one. Smalley.
Yes.
Holt, but he's out there mowing.
You know what? I want Holt is to step in one.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Can you imagine melted marshmallows in your mower blade? Yeah. Gross.
I could just imagine Olsen having that happen too. He'd probably be like, beep,
yeah, beep, a lot of beeps. Beep. Yeah, that's something we probably
But they probably would never listen to this, so they wouldn't know it was us. True story. Yeah.
So our secret's safe.
Yeah.
Right.
Look at that. No one's,
yeah. Okay. Yeah. What else is going on?
Netflix.
Talk to me.
If you guys have not watched these.
I forgot your gift.
You got me a gift?
Yes. It is a Bridgerton-themed hand soap.
Ooh.
Yes.
Okay. Yep. Okay.
Forgot it. Bath & Body Works has a whole line of them, people.
Oh, what? Yeah.
I'm not joking you.
That's what I'd like to hear.
Yeah. I'll bring it next time.
I'm trying to...
Well, some people read the books. Yes. Some of us just waited for the Netflix next series to come out, which it is happening.
Yes, it's out now.
It is. If you haven't started Bridgerton.
Yeah, I have not. I have not because I've been watching these other two things. I know, because I'm waiting. So first off, Lena, you definitely want to watch this. The Kevin Hart Mark Twain Prize. It's number two right now on Netflix.
Okay.
And so Kevin Hart won this like comedy award, the Mark Twain Comedy Award.
It is so good.
What?
It is so, it's funny. It's great. I love Kevin Hart.
Yeah, I do too.
If we ever bump into him.
Yes.
Yes.
We would both be taller.
Way taller.
It would still be great.
It is so good. It was it was emotional, but it was really good because it's kind of like a long, he's receiving this award and then they have all these guests. And so they had some funny stuff. And then, so then that led me to the Tom Brady roast.
Okay. I've seen that pop up.
Yeah.
Not appropriate.
I'm guessing
it's a little,
it's, I mean, it is vulgar. It's really funny. But meanwhile, as everyone's like talking about it, I'm just thinking, wow, some of those are cutthroat and he's just taking it up the backside. I don't know.
Sometimes you just have to learn to have thick skin and get over yourself.
And he wanted to do it.
Yeah.
But then after I watched the Tom Brady roast and I started like looking at the background and like he wasn't. Yeah, he'd never do that again.
Oh.
But so during one of the comedians that was there was Nikki Glaser.
Don't know.
Which I was like, why does that name sound so familiar? And it was because one time somebody said, you know what? You remind me of Nikki Glaser. And I was like, oh yeah. So I looked her up. Okay. She's hot.
Okay.
And then I saw her there on the Tom Brady thing and I was like, okay, I can see it.
Got it.
Yeah. Look her up. She's
I'm more of a Melissa McCarthy kind of resemblance.
Sorry.
Stop.
I mean, she's way prettier than me. And she's got some like eating disorders. She, like the size of my pinky. Oh. So I definitely can see the resemblance there. But
yeah. I will have to look this up.
It was lots of laughter. That's definitely don't watch it with the kids.
Okay.
Lots of F words.
Oh.
But Kevin Hart also, he is managing the roast. So Kevin Hart.
So like, that's why these two kind of came up together. Okay.
Yeah. Got it. It was really good.
So you actually haven't seen Bridgerton. You've seen these two things.
Right. I have not seen the new season.
Okay.
Read all of it.
Are you waiting for all of them to come out and try and watch them all?
No. Okay. I've watched Bridgerton. I just haven't watched this new series.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. There. I was confused.
I've read all the books.
Okay. Yeah. That's it. Yeah.
I'm going to watch it though. Yeah.
Good.
But I've been also watching the Moses one. That's what I watch on the treadmill.
Moses?
Yeah.
You're going to have to send this to me.
It's on Netflix as well. Why is it not here anymore?
I don't know.
But yeah. So, what about you?
I'm still like Amsterdam.
Okay.
And, Resident.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of seasons and they're good. It would be very comparable to probably your Grey's Anatomy, but I don't know if it's as dramatic.
Okay.
I mean, yeah, the medical scenes are dramatic, but the storyline is not as drama filled. Like we haven't had a bunch of people die. Like Grey's Anatomy, somebody like a main character died every other episode, pretty much.
The good looking ones.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it's hard to be good looking people. That's why it's just good to be subpar. I have longevity. Those you good looking folks. Sorry. So you can't have it all.
Are you putting me in that category?
I am. You're pretty beautiful. Did you notice I sent our mics across from each other so I could look at you and just be like, Lena, get your life together. When I wake up in the morning, I think, praise God, Jake gets up before me and doesn't see this. And I have some time to put myself together because that's what's happening now. People, it's summertime.
Oh, yeah.
This librarian is semi-retired, kind of like when I'm actually working, but I am off.
That's kind of me, too. I mean, I'm not wearing any makeup, just little mascara and some eyeshadow. That's it.
Dude.
This is the real face.
Yep. It's beautiful.
All natural. Yeah. On the face.
Yeah.
Yes.
I didn't know where you were
going. I don't know where we were going with that either. Do not know where we're going with it. This summer, though, we're going to have some really awesome people on.
We are. And we're actually scheduling. We understand.
Yeah.
You know, every now and then we get a little hiccup and we're not there when you wake up on Tuesday morning. Mm-hmm. When you go, because that's the first thing you do on a Tuesday, you look for your newest, most favorite podcast. And we aren't always there.
I know. And then people are messaging us and they say,
I know.
Get your lives together.
Yeah. This is, I thought they dropped on Tuesday.
Yeah.
And Jake said that to me when Tuesday night was like, are you guys not dropping them on Tuesday anymore? And I was like,
yeah, or Wednesday morning, whatever.
Yeah.
Jake. I was like,
yeah.
I have one girlfriend that says it just ruins her week if it's not.
I can understand.
I know. I like to hear myself too. Yeah. Also, speaking of, people need to like hire us. Because we are really funny.
We are. And we've been hired.
Mm-hmm.
And we have done really good when we've been hired. Here's the thing. We have not dropped the ball. People have not walked out.
No. That's a good point.
Yes.
That's a very good point.
I mean, we did lock the doors.
And I have so many stories in like the last like 2 months.
Yeah.
My list
of everything.
Yeah.
Yeah. You got to save this stuff.
Because.
Yep.
Bella got taken again. I mean, that right there.
From the same, by the same person?
Yeah, so I'm at the point now, I'm just thinking, do I tell somebody about this woman or,
I'm listening to a podcast right now and it says all about Tammy. It's just crazy.
So it's all about Lori.
Yeah.
I actually don't want to say her name because what if she has a podcast and then she comes and finds me? I don't know, but she took my dog the other day and.
Again. No, you need to say she took my dog again.
Yes. And so then.
This does not happen.
I know. And then I don't know where my mind was, but I was in my PJs, out the car. And then I was like, wait a second. I should have probably bought back up. Like what do I do if I see her with my dog? Luckily though, she was not around the grocery cart and said puppy. So I just got out, swapped up.
Shut the door. She used the grocery cart again to kidnap your dog.
Yes, I know. I just don't understand.
And then did you follow like the cart
tracks? Well, I did until she got to the pavement and then I was just going all over Maywood trying to find her.
No idea.
And
Yeah. What?
Yes. But I found the grocery cart. Bella was hanging out by the grocery cart. And then I'm like, Bella, this is not your person.
No.
Stop.
She's got to have treats. Like, what is going on with Bella? Like, the said cart person has to have like treats or smell like ham.
Ooh.
Ew. I mean, seriously.
Yeah, something.
I don't get it.
I don't know. But, what you know, that right there is, it's a lot.
Yeah. Well, we had a container on our front porch, our kittens. The mom moved.
Oh, congratulations, by the way.
Yes, we have four adorable kittens, and we have a mother hen that hatched out some babies, too. So we're just killing it.
Look at you guys.
I know. They're super adorable.
Mm-hmm.
But she had them in the spot she was supposed to have because we had a cat box.
Mm-hmm.
For some reason, she decided to move them to the front porch, which we have a dog kennel, like a crate, what you would call it. Like, it's not hard plastic. It's like metal. You can see through it. She moved them all there. And then I had this container on the front porch. For some reason, on the other side of said container became their outhouse.
I hate cats. I hate them.
This is the only part of them I really despise. Or when they poop in my flower bed and I'm doing it with my flowers, it smells like
that's cats. My issue right now. All my cool, awesome flower containers are full of cat.
Yep. I had to dispose of two of mine because I'm classy in the country and I was using mineral tubs for my flowers.
Oh, red ones?
Yeah.
Or fancy white, like the cream colored ones.
I have orange ones and gray. Oh, they are beautiful.
I bet.
Yeah. Especially when there's flowers in them. Not when there's 3 inches of cat turds.
Yeah.
And then the liquid secretions soak into the plastic. So even if you change out the dirt, that smell's not going away. So they all had to go babiza.
I'm glad.
Yeah. I should have just I potted them and given Clay a Father's Day bouquet.
Look. Yeah, I got to clean out mine. I'm like,
Speaking. Okay. I planted some new shrubs this year
and
I'm super excited about them.
Ooh,
because I like perennials. I'm sorry. Mama Librarian doesn't got billions of dollars to drop on annuals.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm with you. I'm all about the perennials.
So this stuff's got to come back year after year after year. Mm-hmm. So I did some new, but the upfront cost on that stuff is a little out of, again, said librarian's price range sometimes. Yes.
Yeah.
So instead of like a $3 six pack of whatever.
Yeah.
Those those flowers, I'm spending $20 on a hedge.
Yes.
Whatever.
You know what? I'm the same way.
Yeah. And then I had to argue with my kids if one thing was a weed the other day. I think it was some goat's beard milkweed.
That has like a little purple red flower on it or purple flower on it. Mm-hmm. I'm at the, like, we're not going to be home long enough to plant anything this year. So I'm just, I don't know. I'm like, I might throw out a cucumber or two just to see if they make the cut when we're gone and don't get watered.
Oh, sure. Okay.
But otherwise, I'm not planting anything. Last year, I did find some black flowers, though, but they were annuals.
Yeah.
Again, they cost a lot.
They do cost a lot.
And they were black, so it just, like, matched the trim of my home.
That's amazing.
Fun.
Yes, that is fun.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, outdoor furniture is also very expensive.
Yeah.
Because
all hand-me-downs at our house.
We've had the same wrought iron set for a good going on probably 10 years now. Yeah. And the stuff that doesn't blow away is so expensive. It's just not quite in our budget right now.
It's tough. Or then if you get the fancy ones with the cushions and then your cats piss on them.
Mine have never peed on them, but they do use them to claw, like knead.
Oh.
They get in there and then, you know, and then they start to purr. You know how they do.
Yes.
We still have one of the cats that when it was a kitten, it's a giant black cat. Now it's huge and it looks like it's come back from that movie Pet Cemetery. Did you ever watch that?
Sorry, I'm not thinking of cats right now and I gotta clear off my
Anyway, it's gross. It's this big giant and it still nurses off tough. So I have a little teeny tiny white curly dog that this giant cat comes up and suckles and then kneads into his back. And Tough can try to be walking and this cat is still nursing. It's the most bizarre. I'll share so that you can share videos. It makes no sense.
Interesting.
But it did it
it's
as
like a
kitten.
Funny farm at your house.
It is a little strange. Yes. Huh. What are you most excited about this summer? Okay.
I don't know where that came from.
I don't either.
I guess, I mean, I'm busy, but all my busy stuff is so fun. So
that's awesome.
I get to see one of my girlfriends.
Nice.
I go visit her.
Very good.
So I'm so excited about that. Yeah. And I don't know. I'm excited for like wrestling camp. I'm just excited for everything.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's going to be a busy summer, but a lot of it is also with family. So that's
100%.
Pretty cool. 100%.
Right. Mm-hmm. Same. You know, we talked about last time when we were talking about our three words and I was like, oh, you know, mine was worship, celebrate, and then forgiveness was the other one that I couldn't think of that time. But this, we are actually, you know, again, we planned a vacation and we're just looking at being present. Like when we have the time, just even, you know, like those first couple of days of summer, I can have a list of 600 things that I would like my kids to do. And I'm like, you know what? They were killing it in school. They did what they were supposed to do. They can have a little downtime like we all need. Mm-hmm. And I don't have to be doing something all the time.
Right.
It's okay to take a break.
Speaking of that, you need to give me this softball schedule.
Deal.
Yeah.
Got it.
Send it.
Okay. It's going to be fast and furious. It's going to be over and then
like
summer.
It.
Yeah. I'm me too. Did I tell you the new podcast, The Thing About Pam?
Oh, yeah.
I think I said the wrong name.
I've already listened to that one.
What?
Yeah.
Why didn't you tell me about it?
Oh, that was a long time ago. The Thing About Pam?
Yeah, I guess. Yeah, I don't know. I'm just now listening to it.
Yeah. Old news.
Do you have another one that you've been listening to that's really good?
I haven't because I've been watching TV while I drive.
What? How is that even? What? How do people do that? You can't watch TV while you drive.
Well, it's like if it's up, you can like hear it, you know?
Oh, yeah, sure.
I really haven't been listening to a lot of podcasts here lately. A lot of Ed Milet ones. And I'm also reading. What about reading? What are you reading right now?
I'm reading two different books and also listening to one on Libby.
Okay.
And one is Without Merit. It's a Colleen Hoover was recommended. I've just started, so I can't say.
Yeah.
I know she's. And then the other two that I'm reading, I can't even think of right now because I haven't really gotten into it.
Uh-huh.
So, sorry.
I'm doing Andy Frazella's new book, which is so good. Andy Frazella, if you guys don't know who he is. I like his podcast. Lots of cussing, though. It's his newest book, and I got it, and it's really good. It's like The Mental Edge or Mental Toughness or something, but it's good. Pretty quick read. I'm trying not to like read it really fast.
Good.
And then I'm reading a book with Tom Osborne with my girl Jody. Sheets. We're kind of like studying that and then the Bible. So
good job.
Yeah.
That's our summer. The girls are going to be journaling, reading the Bible.
Yeah. Oh, The Testament of Moses. That's on Netflix.
That's what it is. Yeah. Okay.
So it's good.
Good.
Yeah.
Can the kids watch it?
Oh yeah. But it's basically, it goes over like through Genesis and stuff. And, it also had, it's like the story, but then it also has some people that come in there and like throw out things and just kind of makes you think about,
That sounds really good.
But besides that,
Who are you thankful for today?
Oh, Let's see. I'm going to be thankful for... Can we like come up with something else? Because I was... Am I running out of people? There's so many people to be thankful for, right? I'm going to say my sister-in-law, Sarah. She had graduation here this last week for my nephew, which was really cool. And then they had a branding yesterday. And she just like just puts on some really fun events with her family and makes really good food. And she just makes everyone always feel welcome. And like my kids, like she jumps in to help whenever she needs to when we're at those big events. And
sure.
Yeah, so I'm going to be thankful for Sarah.
That's awesome. I'm going to be thankful for... I don't think I've said Brian and Donetta Schaefer. I don't think I've said them. But they're Kinlan's godparents.
Okay.
Neighbors. And I've known, you know, Brian my whole life. But just those people that you've known forever and you don't have to see him all the time. And when you see him. You know what I mean? Like they're good with it and you're good with it. And everybody moves on and no one's crying over not, you know, not being seen all the time. Anyway. Yeah.
Well... That was fun. This was a...
It was fun.
Good episode.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cats and golf.
Yeah.
What more do you need?
I can't wait till everybody like comes and actually watches this. And we have like a huge...
I feel like what's going to happen with Golf League, and I'm sorry I interrupted you, is going to be kind of like what happened with volleyball. People were coming to watch.
I know. Well, and then we also have been... You've been thrown into the duel because it was...
Oh, good.
Yeah. So we got to like really start preparing. Yeah. So be ready for that. We can talk about that next time.
Sounds good.
Okay. Until next time. Thanks, everybody, for listening to another episode of Coaching, Caffeine, and Comedy. I'm your host, Hayley Kobza.
And I'm Lena.